Alright, welcome back. I'm still Veos.
Are you?
Yeah, I am. I'm pretty sure of it.
So that was a fast bit of action there.
Yep, so this is an interesting map that's actually some. I don't know the name of the map because the title screens are not changed. I don't know if they even have names. So this is a fucking map I hate. That's the name of the map.
Ooh. Okay, we'll call the fucking
map. I love those maps.
Sounds good.
So yeah, the start is very hectic because you start in a position where you can't just stand there and yeah, you have enemies right in front of you, attacking you right away.
Hello, Archfiles.
And there's Archfiles on top of there, just being dicks. And yeah, fuck this map. Right. The music and everything, I...
Oh no, they're just tourists, they're sightseeing, you see?
Yeah, just
just be nice to them.
Just exploding you with balls of fire. Like nothing.
Oh, that's like most tourists.
Yeah.
Is this what it feels like?
So I just updated my grenade launcher because why not? I don't know. I have money.
Oh.
Oh, this is a pretty good way to deal with this annoying like anyone just a duck. Just wanna die and throws the lost souls away.
You know, if you have more money than you can need, just give them to charity or something. Don't upgrade your grenade launcher.
Is charity really going to use blood money? Blood coins?
Oh, yeah, sure.
I think they will.
What's I going to buy with that data canner?
Well, the children need it.
Yeah, I can buy some blood bags. Maybe they can upgrade their grenade launchers. They need them more.
Yeah, they already have children. Dog powers. Like bouncing coins to have fun with. Oh well. So this is a penultimate map. There's this one, and then the last one, and this is done. Equinox.
Yes. Yay!
And this map is pretty different from the others. I mean, it's a rocky setting.
And feels like you walked around forever there.
Yeah, it's pretty weird layout, which a bit confusing at first. Yeah, but
it felt like it was more than a circle. They didn't teleport you or anything, did they?
No. I mean, okay. It's not going to be a teleport pretty soon, but. Not for now. Like, walk to the edge of the circle, no way inside it. That's a pretty cool room. I mean, I like this one. The part I don't like is outside. Like, especially the start part. Like, you don't have really time to see it, but it was like a very narrow, like, ledge you will be working on. And after time I started recording, I would just fall. There's something very bad in the pit.
Yeah.
And actually, it's not damaging throws. Something else. We'll be coming back there a bit further. Oh, and this texture is not moving.
What? Oh.
Yeah. Because it's tied to the sector, like, besides it.
I just thought it didn't move at all.
And, yeah, okay, this part is a bit annoying if you don't play with Psyship, because, yeah.
What?
Basically, what happens, you get in this area without any like radioactive shoots, and I suppose you're supposed to get these elf packs, but yeah, it's still very bad. And I actually died here twice, just getting out of the teleport, getting killed by Kaiko demons right next to me.
It seemed like you spawned on them, except you didn't telefrag them.
Yeah, it's exactly like what happens. So add this to the reason I hate this map. The Archrise, the start, the part you say is pretty annoying.
No, that seems
and
random.
The end is it's kinda retarded. It would be less retarded in normal game because you would have BFG in this level.
Oh, it's spoiler. Not a doom what if it's not retarded.
I guess. Actually I recorded another doom what which is doom not really a what because it has more than just maps. Which is pretty cool, just 6 maps, just no bullshit, just like slight improvements on the gameplay. Some bestiary improvements and I don't know exactly, it's it feels like vanilla gameplay but it's not really. You see that.
Yeah.
Right. Another video. It's one video, the whole video is like 40 minutes and that's the whole 6 maps. And it's pretty good stuff, I mean I had fun with that, not like, you know, this map. Like, this Ashra is right there. The Britannians are just going to push you out of the way and... As I drop some money. I have some money.
Money, money, money.
Yes. Best part about our tribes.
And the rest of them is up here just being dicks. And that kind of stuff. So yeah, every time you want to go up here, you have to take this elevator. Couldn't there be stairs? You have to take
what
this elevator.
What if the tail of the Revenant's missile?
And
the, looks silly.
Oh yeah, I guess. And the other side, what was going before, every time you took the elevator up there, the Ashfly would attack you and you had to go down and wait.
Yeah.
It's dumb.
Oh no, he dropped a diamond. Go down there. Oh no, come back up again.
And that too.
Oh, yeah, I remember that part.
Yep.
It's exercise. It's good for you, Doom Marine. Sure, you can travel at 50 miles per hour, but try this.
Try jumping. Nope.
Yeah, he needs to lose some weight there.
Yeah, and again here, I want to go up, back up, and nope. Oh well.
Wake me when we're there.
Oh, you. So we have to open this. And actually, the way to the next part of there is actually a bit confusing. You see this free monkey bite down here?
Yeah.
It's not where you want to go. You could go there by just try running, but you want to go
in
this
always want to go next to the monkey bite.
I mean, you kill them and go there. I mean, that's what I did the first time I played this. And the second. But you have to go down here first.
Okay.
You understand why I want to get to the end of this spot. Hi!
Ooh, it's a hidden door.
Hello.
Oh, this one went flying and didn't die. It was pretty fun. This part is a bit silly too. So what I'm going to do, I know I'm going to upgrade stuff, yeah. Plasma, I'm going to max it out. Yes, I did.
Sweet.
Plasma max out is really sweet. I'm going to use it against the monkey bar and it's pretty effective. Oh, and yeah, I'm using this. Didn't use that for the first video. Oh yeah! It's bounce shit around. Back.
It's the perfect weapon.
Physics! Well, pseudo-Newtonian physics, but hey.
I guess. Oh, and this part is pretty funny. As soon as you step in, the ceiling starts to fall down and you have to press all these switches, which like most of them are on switches, to open these three like doors.
I'm guessing you died quite a lot here, didn't you?
No, I never died. It's very easy. You just spam your button like a...
How do you even notice that the first time?
It's fine. Even if you don't know, you just go around the world and spam buttons. So here we come here. And you see there's a part we got teleported on that just elevated in front of us with the earth packs?
Yeah.
If you come in from the other side, you will find this pit and it's never going to go up. You'll be stuck.
Oh. That's quite asshole-ish.
It's not asshole-ish, it's just bad design.
I think bad design. Bad
this map is badly designed. It's a bit cool, like the circle part is kinda nice. And it's a bit different than corridors and the stuff we had before. But no, we played everywhere.
I mean, it looked like you were poisoned down in that well type thing too, so... Wasn't really that clear that you needed to go down there.
Indeed, you could have been
there.
Like
were some items,
before.
But I mean... It just looked like an alternate... Like, bonus items or something.
Yeah, it looks like a secret area. Like, you know, like in one map of the three... Forgot, you could go in one... Mount Erebus, I think you could just like run very fast into a secret to get a secret level or something. I forgot.
Nah.
Yeah, I think it takes 9 seconds with a rocket launcher.
Yeah, and here is what you're supposed to do. So yeah, pretty dumb.
Wait, back at the start?
Yeah, back at the start. So you see this thing I worked on, pretty easy to fall when you try to go fast, do not be stuck by demons, right?
Oh, next I thought that was just like shadow or something.
No, it's just pits on the sides, and I'm going to buy, and down here? Oh, hey! And when you can't see anything, it's actually a pretty good trap. I like this trap. It's much more like fun than, you know, damaging frost. Or instability, it's like in TNG. Just demons just itching you out if you fail there. I find that And I'm just farming for money. You know, money.
Can't get enough of it.
Loads of money.
Money, money, money. Dosh.
Lots of dosh.
Indeed. And coins and bonds. And I think I already iced to level 2 right there. And it's already starting to get pretty effective.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if you really watched before, like, when you use plasma, it kills, like, plasma max to kill a monkey by, like, 3 shots, which is the same as a rocket launcher.
Yep.
Which is pretty good. I mean, Dark kills a monkey by in 2 shots, but Dark costs much more energy.
Hello.
So here, I already did plasma myself, so I'm going to max out ice.
Yeah, that wasn't very optimal of you.
Oh, whatever. I wanted to do plasma against a monkey by, so I'm not
wasting money.
Well, ice seems like a pretty decent crowd.
Yeah, I know against demons and imps it's instant death. And yeah, even this this was an L9, pretty sure. But it's pretty fast. Yeah, I couldn't really see the course. And yeah, you look at this part, that's the end of the level. I mean, what the fuck is going on there?
Okay. A party!
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Circle in the sea party, I don't know.
Yeah, and then what this happens.
Oh, hey.
So basically, you could see it from far.
Okay, like, how did you
there's
not
an icon
that?
Of sin hidden in the ground. That spawns enemies indefinitely, and spawns a lot of them. So I think that normal like Doom gameplay, you should do that with the BFG, because before like the Psyche Crystal thing is a BFG normally.
You just disable the damage from the Starch Fest, right?
I think you turned around to shoot somewhere else. Just before, I was lucky again. I promise not beating the
Your
game,
luck will run
hard,
out
right?
sometime.
Accurate
Mr. French guy.
Right in this spot. So usually you can do that by just like stopping time and killing stuff until you get to the end. But this time I think I did something a bit different. And actually fucked up a bit. Like I used terror, which is very good because it's stopping enemies from attacking me most of the time. And instead of buying, I think I bought the wrong thing to die, let me check. No. Yeah, about the one thing I wanted to buy Psycho, which is the thing that makes your weapons very, very good. I said about Vampire. I was like, fuck, I have no money to buy Psycho. But actually it's working pretty well because enemies not really attacking him much. And when
except
I get
now,
attacked, my health goes up again, even when I use ice.
Right, you have Vampire, don't you?
Yeah. And it's out, like you can see the top right.
Yep.
Bonus
deep frozen vampiric powers.
So yeah, this was really annoying. You have to get to the top and get to the exit, but every time enemies respawn, just near you. I don't think you can get telefrag because I don't see the like bottom level. I'm exactly sure of that. Never got telefrag here. And yeah, I'm pretty surprised I did that one go that smoothly. Usually this part is a bitch. We don't have PFG.
Oh, you missed a lot of kills there.
Yeah, and bad one secret base. That before I couldn't get.
Oh, we're back here.
And this is the end, and we're back at first level, which is a pretty cool thing.
What's up with it?
And everything went different.
It's
like hieroglyphs
circle,
or something.
It?
Yeah, it went alien, you could say.
Hmm.
And of course, when you do remakes, you have to keep those secrets. It's like in M3, M9.
Hello there.
And I have no clue what to do with these technologies. There's no, just like this one, and at least one other. So I just did that. I'm not supposed to do this, but I'm like, whatever, I'm just grenade jumping up here. And I think that the grenade jumping is shit now. I mean, you never saw it before, but when the grenade launcher got changed and made much better because it didn't kill you much, you had much, as much, much.
Oh. As
much. Much, 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 much.
Yes.
Much more.
What happened is that it became terrible to do rocket jumps. But now you can do it with plasma instead, so that's fine. I just like, oh wait, there's plasma to rocket jumps and down. So it's plasma jumps.
I don't know about that plasma jump, I don't think it's gonna catch them.
As long as you can do it, eventually it's fine with me.
Propelling yourself with the fourth state of matter.
Yeah.
Plasma jumping!
And gas jumping.
Gas
jumping! And gas jumping! And liquid.
Please don't elaborate on that.
So this level, you see, the start of the level is pretty cool. It's nice, the textures, it's a bit different. But when you get to the main part of the level, it's going to be I have no word to say that. And the secrets are a bit pointless, like there's this energy sphere here, there's another you can get which is back, like up one of the secrets just in the main corridor of the room before. And it's an invulnerability. If you get it, you can't get to the far part of the level in time to actually use it.
So
and to get the secret, you have to go to this far part. And it's actually know where all the secrets are on this one, or to get them normally, but I won't because it's pointless. I already don't need them, and
yeah.
I would take much time. As this level takes a bit of time already, and I hate it too.
Ooh, you got a shotgun.
Yeah, that should be a backpack. But that makes no sense, so I should get in here. <Doesn't it? laughs> So at this point, I'm getting money. I'm not going to buy any grades at this point. I'm keeping everything for power-ups.
Yeah, makes sense.
Like health and stuff, because, you know, that's the last level, isn't it?
Yep. You know, I prefer to think of this as a sort of Lovecraftian story, when you unearth a plot by an ancient god, and now you have to fight him in this big giant battle.
Yeah, pretty much. That actually sounds like a real thing. There's not really backstory in this. I mean, it's just implied, which is... I mean, a good way to have backstory in my opinion, instead of having cutscenes and worlds in your face. Like, games do. Having something implied is much more cooler.
Yeah, you can make your own interpretations.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what happened with Half-Life, pretty much.
Yeah.
Especially the first one, like, you see signs and stuff, but you never knew exactly what was happening, so you had to, you know, figure it out.
Well, same was with Doom, I suppose. And Quake, I guess.
Quake was a big mess.
yeah, Quake was the whole
it wasn't,
thing was
that wasn't planned. And like here that. We come to the second part of the level in a second. It's a big one. So,
ooh, shiny.
I don't know if you heard, but when I opened the door and shot, you're like... So, every one of these big pillars, you see, in the left, so I have two cyber demons in one of them.
Ah, two of them.
And
on
the top
other.
Of the middle structure, there's four spider masterminds. And there's like imps and knights and cacos and monkey bys and everywhere. And like here, this is a big dickish. Like you have this elevator, you have to wait, and in front of it, you have remnants.
Worked out fine though.
Hmm?
It worked out fine though.
Yeah, you can dodge them, so it's fine. It's kind of funny. And we need a red key.
Yeah, let's jump into the pit.
Yeah, it's not like Death Wire.
Oh.
What was it? Death Wire is damaging for us.
Death Water.
Death Wire. That reminds me of something. Didn't someone use that before? I completely forgot. Oh wait. So yeah,
I don't know.
This is a mess, and killing everyone is not an option. Like these cyber demons, even with doom weapons, just shooting them with plasma guns for years. It's interesting. At least there's a psycho down here, so I can clear up this place up here.
Yeah.
So you need to. Yeah.
Oh no! I'm just.
Are you hurting yourself there?
I'm not dying in this video.
No, I think I was RPing as Doom.
Oh.
Yeah, I should stop that.
No, that's a quick guy.
I put on my armor and Doom Marine hat.
It's a helmet. Oh well, so yeah, this part is pretty tedious. Like, I have to clear out this part up here to be able to actually move there. And just, well, I have to for this. I'm making good usage of my psycho. My usage.
What?
Yeah, I could just go up here, but I'm just using this thing. Grenade launcher is so good.
Oh, yeah.
It's
running around like a little chicken.
Well, okay, I have a challenge for you. Do this level, I could give you my save if you want, and you kill everything. Not cheating.
No problem.
I can't see to
see. Sometimes I'm gonna run out of ammo.
Like 4 hours.
Well, I've
so here is a key.
Oh,
key. And the first time I couldn't figure it out because I was just saying that Marine from far, that's not a key. And it took me a time to find it.
Yeah, did that before though.
It's a really cool way to give you a key, but
nope,
it's not obvious.
Raining money.
Yeah, it's running money, literally. Like, boink. Ah, it's not pounds though. I wish it was, you can't pounds. here, I'm like, yes, just buying one terror thing so the monster stops, so several demons stop shooting at me for a while. Everything seems so more calm now.
Yeah, and this music, it's like, ooh, yeah, it's a care like, in the world.
That's what it is, yeah, pretty much. So this part, again, I don't like. The way up is here, but you have to walk around to just find it.
Yeah, it's very huge.
And if you don't have terror on, you have cyber demons even left. One is firing me right now. Cyber demons just firing at your face if you try to wait at the elevator. Same way if you try to get up into the middle.
Hmm.
Oh, and by the way, the way back is closed.
Well, I guess that makes sense.
Yeah, no, actually it's a bit dumb because there's two secrets that put you back at the start and you can get back there just opening the door again. But you have to go back in the like in right or right and press a switch again, which is annoying. So that's why you can't reach the invulnerability well, because you have to go press that switch and get back here and nope, it's too late. Make any use of that.
Oh, more bad design, I suppose.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't really like everything else in Equinox, but these two levels. I mean, this one is pretty cool, I guess, but it's, I don't like it. I don't like playing it. It's tedious. Wow. It's not tedious in the sense like in Alien Vendetta where you just like spam BFG. Here, enemies are far and you can't really kill them. Like, cyber demons. No, it's just too far and. I don't even know if you have any ammo in the map to do this.
Mm. I suppose I could try this map, seeing as I finished Daikatana on hard, but I guess I'll take your word.
No.
Nope.
Don't brag about finishing Daikatana on hard.
Yeah, that's not gonna get me laid in.
Yeah, playing Doom anyway.
Unlike other games.
Yes.
Hey, I played Doom talk about your Nightmare. I finished it in one day.
Yeah, indeed.
You played a game called Leisure Suit Larry? Here, let me show you what I learned.
Actually, that's pretty funny because no one did play these games. Just in thread. That's,
yep.
Yeah, Legion. They're taking a Leisure Suit. So, okay, this part here, you have to find four of these switches to, like, there are four walls that are in the way to get to the top of the center area.
Okay.
That's one, and this place here, this area is very annoying. You see, there's sixth hole here, right? And five of them leads you aside, and one of them is the right one. But the one that leads you back leads you like back at the bottom of the pit, and or back at the start of the level, and it's terribly annoying. So there's like one that leads back there, and yeah. You have to know it or else you spend a lot of time. Imagine going back and forth from the start to the bottom of a river like four times.
Yeah.
That adds to the tediousness of the level.
Oh, plasma's doing pretty well here.
Yeah, our plasma is doing very well fully graded. Too bad it takes so much time for it to make this effective.
Yep. Yeah.
Again, it's pretty efficient, like energy cost and damage it does. So I like it. I didn't like it at first, but stuff. And this part is really funny. So you get this energy sphere and you're like, hey, oh, hey! That's a bunch of lava and demons in the way. So here what you're supposed to do is dodge the guys and use the ash rise to jump over them, but you know, since we're a bit chained, I have most look, I can do this.
Yay! Demon surfing!
Yeah, pretty much. It's pretty fun.
Demons don't surf.
And like, oh, whoops!
No,
whoops.
You surf demons!
It was a bad Charlie Don't Surf reference, I don't know.
You are the surfer, John.
No, don't make it. Don't do it.
And then...
No.
Nope,
and
we're
then
not gonna
a
make
bad
it.
Joke. No, stop.
Oh yeah, you froze him in twice and then he got slammed by the door.
Yes.
At least that's what I'm gonna think of it as. You didn't shoot him at all.
And
hey, you lowered the spinny thing.
Second wall. Oh yeah, this appears here for some reason. I don't know if you managed to do that with like not using like Doom normal stuff. I know it teleported this away. I think it might have been in the floor and then some elevator got it up or something. I'm not sure.
Cool.
It's something you usually can do in normal Doom maps, in classic Doom maps, I would say.
Yeah. Spawning
it's
stuff.
Very easy to do with scripts, like, oh, you press switch, this thing appears, but this thing has no scripts, no SES code, no decorate, nothing. This is classic. You can bring pretty much any port. Equinox, not psychic, you see. Oh, when you're outside, too, there's a Spider Mastermind being dicks and shooting at you all the time.
Yep, of course.
But this part, come on. There's this weapon getting out of your reach if you're not quick enough. And then, yeah, this is. Good penance. Stay there, please.
Oh, they're just strutting around, minding their own business.
Yeah, just you know, spitting glass over your face.
Yeah.
Just that.
Well, it's
being
natural.
Fucking
it's
dicks, goddammit! Oh!
Yeah. Pain elementals are not nice.
At one point, I just like tried to run back, and the Rash Fry came in, and I couldn't dodge him, and she died. And that's the third thing. Oh, here is something again that's annoying. Like, you get about here, so you, by instinct, you go forward and fall again down here.
Yeah. That's
and like, damn wow. It! And you do it like three times in a row, and like, no, stop.
Yeah. I mean, you know it's gonna happen, but you don't. You just do it by instinct, or yeah. By.
Not pretty much. I'm looking on some map. Sometimes you go to teleport and you, like walk back, and sometimes you, when you go back and teleport, and you be stuck in teleport loop. Like if you go forward, you teleport again back where you were, and so on. Oh, and yeah, this corridor pass when you get in there, it's a little maze, and the top ceiling is falling.
Oh,
it'll be quick, but you know after playing this map a few times, you know.
I didn't even notice.
Yeah, because it was Sonic.
You were Sonic?
Yes. Actually got lost one time.
Oh.
And when you get here to the end, it stops. Actually, I don't know what happens if it stops when it's too close to ground. Not sure. I don't want to try. I'm pretty sure you could get stuck if that happens. Like, it's almost down, and you walk at the end just before. He walks down the area, you can't walk.
Maybe it races to the top. Or maybe it's just better designed.
Yeah, maybe that too!
Yes.
I think you have a point here, maybe that's what I'm trying to say for these two maps. Sure, it looks cool, but. Yeah.
Yes, air buying!
Yeah.
You wait to buy shit!
Let's just buy one of the terror because I want to be shot by sediments and do this all over again. Not really hard, but again, it's. I guess Psychic is not too bad when you have like Alien Vendetta style maps where you have tons of enemies because you can just have you have so much money you can buy overdrives all over and over again and just spam dark all day.
Yep.
So here you see that the ground is a four thing we just lowered.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, yep. If you come there before it's like, oh, what?
Oh, right. The rites of passage.
I guess. Okay, that's actually kinda cool to have to go to four different areas with four gimmicks. But it didn't work so well. I'll get out. Actually, one time I died here, because for some reason they wouldn't like die and fall. They were stuck and they just shot me to death.
Boom.
Alright, so with this guy dealt off, I'm going to find entrance in a few minutes. Come on.
Yeah, just keep walking around, you might find.
Yeah. So we go, that down. This is the final room.
Whoa.
And I'm going to have made it completely easy by using. Again. Okay. Everything.
Everything.
Okay, I have regenerate, I have guard, I have. Enemies attack me less, I do two times the damage. And
oh, but you don't have a radiation suit.
Yeah, you're right.
What if you have to walk on damage to. Floor?
Yeah, it becomes a joke because I'm like, they're not even attacking me because I have terror on. Like, I don't know about it. It's anticlimactic.
Wow.
But to show you that, yeah, you play with trash, like, you're pretty powerful if you know which power to use.
Well,
and here we go, everything is dead in this room.
That's it.
Oh, what? Nope.
Okay, so this switch gonna blow up the world, I guess?
Yes. So, yeah, I have to say goodbye now. Thanks for watching this. And miss you for a few more before, you know, Legacy of Suffering.
Hey.
Yay.
Goodbye.